Welcome back to our Children's Worship Online again. We are so glad to be able to meet you all in this manner, to be able to bring the worship and the lessons to you every Friday. How have you been? Are you getting used to study online at home? I believe that there's many changes that you have to adjust and adapt it to. But one thing we are for sure, that is God is in control of all situations and circumstances. So we can always put our trust in Him and believe that God will make all things beautiful in His time. So without further delay, I would like to let you know that we have come up with about 13 songs, worship action songs, or praise and worship songs in our YouTube channel. And through the weeks, if you are having time, free time at home, please chat with your parents and ask them to log on to our PCO YouTube website. Then you can listen to all the songs, sing along and do the actions together. This morning, we are glad to have teacher Jenny with us and his sons to lead us into the time of worship. Let's move on to our worship now.
Hello everyone, come on, join us. Let's see My Lighthouse.
You are the peace, you are the joy, see.
Lord is the light unto our path. So now let us worship the Lord. Let's sing Waymaker. for keeping us, Lord, always, Lord, safe, Father God. Thank you, Lord, for doing miracles today. All these things we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
We thank Teacher Jenny and Samuel for the time of worship together. This week, we are very blessed to have Teacher Sharon teaching us the lessons on the shipwreck. And it is taken from Acts chapter 27, verse 13 to 44, chapter 28, verses 11 to 16. The main point we are learning is God protected Paul in the shipwreck so that he could stand before Cephas to preach the gospel. Just as God protected Paul, God will protect us and enable us to share the gospel. The memory verse is taken the same verses from Philippians chapter 1 verse 20 to 21. Teacher Sharon will give you the detail of the summary verse later in her teaching. And this week, we are excited that she comes up with a wonderful object lesson to show us how preaching the gospel at times is such a difficult task, but if we have the Holy Spirit with us, we can do it and spread the gospel out throughout the world. And you can watch these object lessons and with her teaching and her craft. Enjoy and be blessed.
Hello kids, I hope you are doing well. Now we are going to see a very quick object lesson. Let's go. Okay kids, so here, this white milk represents the world. And these represents people living in the world. People that you know, friends that you know. So let's try sharing the good news with all these people. Okay? Uh-oh, nothing's happening. The first thing you need in your life is Jesus. So when we accept Jesus as our Savior and when we believe that He died for us and He rose again and He loves us so much and Jesus gives us the Holy Spirit. So let's try with the help of the Holy Spirit. Wow, you can see how fast the gospel is being spread across. So when you have the Holy Spirit inside you, He will help you and He will enable you to share the good news with others. Last week, Auntie Sunita taught us about Paul sharing the good news with governors and king. Today, we are going to talk about Paul's journey to Rome. So Paul is going to meet Caesar. So when he and other prisoners, they got onto the ship and they were traveling to Rome. So when they got onto the ship, they all packed everything and they were all settled down. And as the ship was going on the sea, it was going along the shore of Crete. There was a place called Crete. It was going along the shore of Crete. So that time, you know, they had some wind blowing and the waves were crashing and all that. When they came along to a small island called Corda, it was heavy battering of sea. It was heavily, there was so much of wind and they could not tolerate. It was heavy wind. And all the people in the boat, they got so scared. Just imagine being in a ship and the waves are tossing and there were heavy winds across you. Can you imagine? You'd be obviously scared, right? And these people are running around here and there. It was so much heavy wind. They don't know what to do. So they tried a trick. You know what they did? They thought, let's throw everything out from the ship to the ocean. Let's throw everything, whatever we have, let's throw everything, because the ship is wobbling and it was heavy wind. And so they tried this. They started throwing everything, whatever they found and had, they started throwing into the ocean. Yes, So like this, they started throwing whatever their hands could find. But still there was heavy wind and the ship was tossing. They were all crying and they lost all the hope. You know what, kids? Sometimes, even in life, when we are going through situations like this, we started to throw things out like anger, frustration, doubt, and everything. But God is asking us to do only one thing. I'll tell you what, okay? So what happened? They started throwing everything and they are saying all hope is gone. Paul was on the ship and one night, an angel of the Lord, he appeared to Paul and he said that no one in the ship will be harmed, that Paul will go to Rome safely, that he will stand trial with Caesar and that he will meet Caesar and nobody in the ship will die, but the ship will break. Okay, so immediately Paul, he went around and he started telling other people, you know, we stay calm, because imagine it was all, you know, ocean or tossing, heavy wind. Can you imagine the situation? Oh my God, it's so scary, right? So Paul went and told, calm down, calm down. The angel of the Lord told me that we will be safely taken to Rome. So Paul told all the people to stay calm. He encouraged them. Imagine at that situation, Paul gave a word of encouragement to other people, right? And these people, they did not eat for many days because the ocean was tossing. They were all so scared. Do you guys get seasickness? Yes, imagine those people in the ship, they would have got, they'll be throwing up and, you know, they'll be falling sick and everything. They did not eat at all. So Paul, he took some bread. So Paul took some bread and he gave thanks to the Lord and he gave to all the people and they all ate. Okay, so it's a clean hands, you can see. So they all ate. So what should we do when we are going to similar situation, like when we are going through a tough time, when it's like storms in our lives? What we should do, what we should feed on? We have to feed on God's promises. There is only one thing that we can tackle the storms in our life, is feeding ourselves with God's promises and by trusting His promises. Okay? So after they all had eaten, the ship went and struck a sandbar and the ship started to break. And some of the officers, they thought the prisoners will run away and they tried to kill some people. But Paul was safe. And God, just as He promised Paul that He will make it to Rome, God kept His promises. And the same time, Paul also trusted His promises. He not only just trusted God's promises, but he was also encouraging other people. So when you feed yourself, when you trust God, when you feed yourself with God's promises, in the same time, you can encourage other people who are going through similar situations. Like when they have hard time studying or when they are having some issues, you can be helpful to them. So the boat struck on a sandbar and it broke, and all the people, they swam and they came to the shore. And Paul stayed there and he again got into another ship and he reached Rome. So if you can see, God gave a promise that He will keep Paul safe. He said that all the people in the boat will be saved, right? So God kept His promises. And if you notice one thing, Paul, even in that situation, he was encouraging other people. He was sharing the good news that he had in his heart to the other people. The same way, even when we are going through tough times, we have to tell other people about Jesus. So when can we share the good news to people? Only when we are happy? Only when things are going well around us? No, just like Paul, even when we are going through tough time, we have to share the good news with other people. So let's learn this week's memory verse together. Philippians 1, 20 and 21. I eagerly expect and hope that I will in no way be ashamed, but will have sufficient courage so that now, as always, Christ will be exalted in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, to live is Christ and to die is gain. Let us pray. Our dear loving Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for your word. Lord, in Paul's life, we saw how encouraging he was to other people, even during his tough and hard times. Father God, help us also to share your good news to other people and to be witness for your name. Father God, you protect us and you guide us. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Okay, kids, I've got a craft for you. It's very, very easy. All you need is a jar, okay? So this craft is called as prayer jar, okay? So all you need is a jar and few sticks, like ice cream sticks that you can find, and you can decorate it. Like, see how Auntie had decorated with some with an hairband and with some beads. And you need a black color pen or any sketch, and you have to write your prayer here. So what, if you can see here, it says pray for your friends. This stick says pray for your friend. So when you take this stick out, pray for your friends. So you can immediately pray for your friends. Let's see what do the other sticks say. Pray for the nation. So you can pray for the nation. Take a minute and pray for the nation, like, Lord bless the nation. Okay, just a 2 minute or 3 minute prayer. So likewise, you can write lots of prayer and you can put it inside with this pen, and you can take it, read it out, and you can pray. So this is the prayer jar.
Indeed, it is so true that just as Paul trusted God, we can trust in God. Teacher Sharon has bring the lesson so clear to each one of us. And I hope you also get to do the craft that she has mentioned and enjoy praying for people, for yourselves, and for the nations. And as you pray, God will bless you so much in return. And the week of these lessons has come to an end. I pray that this week onwards, you will put your trust in God. And knowing that God is in control of all situations, you can always rejoice and trust in Him. And we will see you again next week. Bye!